Welcome back. Village panchayats have started demolition of the illegal structures in CRZ zone. The action started from Monday in Pedne. Velsao panchayat will start theirs after their feast. Central Environment Minister Jairam Ramesh has assured that the dwellings will be protected. But the demolition has begun and still there is no response from the centre on the issue.
The illegal structures on the CRZ area at Morji village were demolished on Monday. Altogether, 9 structures were demolished. Some structures will be demolished by the Panchayat Authority at Hermal and Mandre. Joint Mamladar and PWD engineers were present during the demolition. Penne Mamladar Bhushan Savoykar informed us more on the demolition.
डिमॉलिशन सीआरझ ऑथॉरिटी ऑर्डर प्रमाण के सीआरझ ऑथॉरिटी बाकी जी स्ट्रक्चर आता ती पंचायत मोटली
टोटल पंचायत कितनी मोटली सर
ती पंचायती एक्चुअली 21 स्ट्रक्चर आशी पुन थोड़े कि स्टे मिला संगली ती पंचायत ऑथॉरिटी टू आइडेंटिफाई विच आर द स्ट्रक्चर टू बी डिमॉलिश्ड
ऑन द अदर साइड वेल्सो पंचायत हैज गिवन एन अंडरटेकिंग टू द कलेक्टर दैट द पंचायत विल सून डेमोलिश द स्ट्रक्चर्स The 23 illegal structures would be demolished by the panchayat after the feast.
As per the order of the Honorable High Court, I am come along with my all demolition squad. But the sarpanch has given me undertaking to panchayat is removing at their own. Yeah, 23 structures are there. So panchayat secretary and sarpanch has given undertaking. They are removing at their own. So at their request, I have said okay, and then they are filing the compliance report.
We talked to them also, we talked to their concerned deputy collector and we have taken the state forward and we are with the cooperation of the people, we will try to demolish it.
Our reporter in Pedne, Vinod Mehtar, and in Velsao, Samir Bhatt.
The accused in the Russian rape case, John Fernandez, has withdrawn special leave petition in the Supreme Court. John had appealed in the Supreme Court for stay on High Court's order. Sources say that John is likely to surrender before the state crime branch within the next 48 hours.
John Fernandez withdrew his special leave petition in Supreme Court on Monday. He had earlier filed his plea to the Session Court at Madgaon to grant him anticipatory bail. After Session Court granted him the anticipatory bail, the officials of crime branch challenged the order of the Session Court before the Goa bench of Bombay High Court. Later, John had moved his plea to the Supreme Court challenging the order of the High Court. But the Supreme Court rejected his anticipatory bail application. John Fernandez is accused of allegedly raping a Russian girl. The Russian girl stated that she was dining with her friend and the accused John. She also said that John offered to reach them to their respective places and after dropping her friend first, John tried to rape her. PI Sunita Savant informed that John has no other option but to surrender himself to the crime branch at the earliest.
Their advocate said that he is withdrawing the application and it was allowed to be withdrawn. He has to surrender. There is no way out. He cannot run away from the law. He has no option at all.
A senior reporter Rakesh Kandolkar with video journalist Shan.
Madgaon Sessions Court will hear Calvert's anticipatory bail petition on Tuesday. The matter was adjourned today. Court has extended interim bail to Calvert till Tuesday. Kolwa cars had gathered in huge numbers outside the court to build up the pressure for Calvert's arrest.
Calvert's anticipatory bail hearing was scheduled on Monday at Sessions Court, Madgaon. But the court has postponed it for Tuesday. Advocate Radharao Gracious gave details of the postponement of the order.
No, our case is that, you see, the provisions of Section 153A and Section 295A of the IPC are not affected. That both these sections deal in a different context altogether, where feelings of a religious group are being affected.
Gracious argued that the controversial CD do not attract Section 153A and Section 129 of the IPC. Gracious said that the court will give its verdict after considering the arguments.
Moreover, even assuming it is attracted for some purpose, the arrest of the accused is not at all required. See, they have already recorded several statements. The name of the persons who recorded the CD are contained on the CD itself. All those who have sung the songs, the names are recorded in the CD. And the accused, that is the applicant, does not dispute that he made the CD. He says that he has made the CD. So therefore, there is absolutely no question of the accused being required in custody. This is our case. Of course, it is for the court to take the arguments into account. and apply the law and pass orders.
Kolwa residents had demanded immediate arrest of Calvert if court denies him the bail. A reporter from Madgaon, Ramesh Naik Raut.
Goa State Museum has exhibited old Goan embroideries for Museum Week celebrations. Some embroideries dating from the year 1880 have also been displayed.
These saris were produced in year 1880. It has attractive embroidery work. Most of the embroideries exhibited at the museum are from pre-liberation era. This fine work of Goan embroidery will be open till 8th of January. This will mark the Museum Week celebrations.
Actually, this year we have taken embroidery as our theme for the Museum Week, and we have a temporary exhibition of the embroidery works. We had arranged a Nari Shakti exhibition few days back, and we got very good response. So we decided to have some old embroidery, collect some old embroidery samples and have an exhibition. And that exhibition we have set up for next 5 days. The ladies from Goa responded us very well.
Goa State Museum has 14 galleries of artifacts of Goa's history. It is one of the biggest museums in Goa, but very few people visit this museum. This museum is mirror to Goan history, and one can learn a lot after visiting it. A senior reporter from Panji, Rakesh Kanolkar, with video journalist Shan for Prudent Media.
Let's take a short break. Stay tuned.